suffered a broken bone in his right wrist last June. He has not fought in 11 months. Here we go. WBC rules, thus a 12-round championship fight. And if the referee, who in this case is Arthur Mercanti, so decides, a standing 8-count can be ordered. Ramirez out of Mexico, a southpaw, a reported record of 83-3. But he dealt in relative obscurity for quite some time. It wasn't until late 1980 when he fought Alexis Arguello that he came into some form of prominence, as Arguello won a split decision in Miami. Meanwhile, Rosario, a reported 24-0 with 23 knockouts. He's been the distance just one time, at a 10-rounder in Vegas in 1981. But again, the fractured right wrist. He had it in the cast for 4 months, and it's only been within the last 6 weeks that he was able to test it out at full speed. Good right. First time he employs it here in the first round. Rosario has been fighting as a junior lightweight, but he was ranked number one in this class by virtue of his victory, very impressively, over another Puerto Rican, Edwin Viruet, in Las Vegas last May. That was the last time Rosario fought, because the injury occurred in a sparring session a couple of weeks after that, as he was preparing to fight Cubanito Perez. Good combination by Rosario. Ramirez, a crafty fighter. On a couple of instances in that fight with Arguello in 1980, it looked like he was in trouble, but then he was able to counter effectively, and indeed had Arguello in trouble at one particular point, had him down on the canvas in the seventh round. First round action from Puerto Rico. Ramirez also took on the WBA champion, Ray Boom Boom Mancini, and that was perhaps the low light of his career, as he lost the unanimous decision, was very nearly shut out on all of the cards. Contended that the ring surface that day was too slippery for him. Rosario pressing the action in the first round. Ramirez backing up for the most part. Half a minute to go in round one. WBC World Lightweight Championship at stake. Ramirez trying to work his way into the left that was picked off. Now Ramirez starting to press the action with that right jab. Rosario coming back with a right that was partially picked off as the first round concludes in San Juan. We're back live, San Juan, Puerto Rico, the Roberto Clemente Coliseum, WBC World Lightweight Championship, black trunks. Edwin Rosario of Puerto Rico, blue trunks, Jose Luis Ramirez of Mexico. Arthur Mercanti, the veteran referee, who has been the third man in the ring for some 40-odd world championship fights, and recognized by many as the world's best in his profession. He does not have a voice in the scoring. The three judges at ringside will do the scoring. Three knockdown rule is waived. Mandatory 8-count in effect, and as we mentioned, Mercanti can issue a standing 8-count, no saving by the bell except in the 15th round. Three judges from Dallas, Arlen Spider Bynum from Las Vegas, Lou Tabbitt from Los Angeles, Lou Filippo. Second round action. Not much real hitting thus far in the round. For the most part, it was Rosario pressing the action in the first round until the waning second. Good right there. But Ramirez is a good counterpuncher, as he proved against Arguello. Another right, and a good right by Rosario. The crowd really coming to life as he has Ramirez backing up, but Ramirez came back, as we mentioned. He's a great counterpuncher. Being a southpaw, he came back with a right hook that forced Rosario back after Edwin was very much pressing the issue. He did get Edwin's attention with the right hook. 1 minute remaining in the second round. proving that. But both quite crafty and skillful. Here comes Rosario again, putting that pressure on. Rivera's trying to keep him off with a sticking right. And Mercanti steps in to separate them. Under a half minute remaining in the second round. Live from San Juan, Puerto Rico. Folks down here with great anticipation for this fight. And of course, it's a pro-Rosario crowd. He lives just 20 miles away from San Juan. Second round ending. We're back live in San Juan, Puerto Rico. We want to welcome those of you who have watched the Boston-Michigan USFL game. I'm Al Michaels reporting from ringside. At stake, the WBC World Lightweight Championship. Black trunks, Edwin Rosario of Puerto Rico on the left, and the blue trunks, Jose Luis Ramirez of Mexico. The two fighting for the vacated lightweight crown, vacated when Alexis Arguello decided to concentrate his efforts in the junior welterweight class in January. Thus, Rosario ranked number one, Ramirez ranked number two. Rosario, a fractured bone in his right wrist last June, has not fought since May of 1982. Rosario, undefeated, 24-0 with 23 knockouts. And Jose Luis Ramirez, a reported 83-3 with 69 of his wins coming by way of the knockout route. Ramirez, the southpaw. First round, Rosario put most of the pressure on. It was a relatively inactive round, but it was Rosario, the aggressor early. Then in the second round, Rosario appeared to sting Ramirez, but Ramirez, a very effective counterpuncher, came back with, and keep in mind he's a southpaw, he came back with a right hook that pushed Rosario away and certainly gained his attention. And thus the round perhaps could have been scored for either man. Three judges at ringside doing the scoring. Good right by Rosario. The referee, Arthur Mercanti, no voice in the scoring. Third round. Michigan game, it is over, and the final score was 28-24. Michigan Panthers winning it. Here, 25 seconds remaining. We're in the third round. Ramirez trying to work his way inside. A good left by Ramirez. Ramirez, 24 years old. Rosario, 20. WBC World Lightweight Championship fight from San Juan into the third round right here. Fourth round action. This has the makings of a good one. Lightweight championship at stake, WBC version. Edwin Rosario, the black trunks. On the left, Jose Luis Ramirez of Mexico in the dark blue trunks. Corner and see if he's effective here using that right jab, but Rosario is able to work his way out. 20-foot ring here in San Juan. Rosario, quite mobile, controlling the pace and tempo thus far in the fourth round. not been able to do much landing. As you can see here, again, he's got Rosario in the corner. He didn't do anything with him the last time he had him there. Now he tries to work inside, work into the body. Rosario with a good right. So a good right landed by Rosario off the rope. Like to alert our local stations along the line. At the end of this round, we'll be taking a station break. We have just over a minute remaining in the fourth round. Off most of those punches. Rosario again backed into the corner. Too many clean punches in the last couple of exchanges. Ramirez starting to throw a few more punches. A quick left by Rosario. And he comes back with a left hook with under a half minute to go in the fourth round. Left in the fourth round, and we'll return with more of ABC's Wide World of Sports after this from our local live in San Juan. Fifth round action with a WBC World Lightweight Championship at stake. Close fight to this point. You could make a case, and we have, for giving Rosario perhaps all of the rounds to this point, yet there has not been any domination by Rosario, and neither fighter has really taken charge. As we are in the fifth round here, as Ramirez, who showed good mobility in the fourth round, comes out with the same sort of foot movement here in round five. Rosario, who was backed against the rope a couple of times in the fourth round, hand punch coming off the rope just as Edwin Buriuet. He did that, knocked him down in the second round and knocked him out in the third in Vegas. Crowd chanting Chapo, Chapo, the nickname, the name he wears across his waist on the black trunks. There is a C there. There it is, and he turns. Good left by Ramirez and a wild right. But he did score with a left hand. Rosario turning. But now back comes Rosario. And the crowd getting to its feet and chanting as Rosario puts the pressure on. But Ramirez backs off the rope. Now he's got Rosario in the corner. Ramirez, a good left hand coming out of the corner by Rosario. Fifth round, again almost by design he gets himself into the corner because he's been effective working himself out of there. 45 seconds remaining in the fifth round. To counterpunch, and so periods of inaction as they await the others, awaiting the instigation of action. Good right again by Rosario. Been a good round for him. His best and the best round of the fight thus far. Waning seconds of the fifth round. A good one and another good short right by Rosario with the WBC lightweight crown stake. Rosario again live now, round six. WBC lightweight championship live. We're in San Juan, Puerto Rico. Capacity crowd of 12,000 looking on at the Roberto Clemente Coliseum. Their man, Rosario. We have him ahead on our card in the black trunks. Interestingly, Rosario, from one of the nearby towns, and yet he has not fought Rosario, who had a great round in round five, and has yet to throw a punch here in the sixth round. Moving, but not doing anything with his hands to this point. Now he again works his way out of that corner. Something he was very effective at doing in round five. Two fighting for the lightweight championship. The crown vacated by Alexis Arguello. Ray Boom Boom Mancini is the WBA lightweight champion. comes Rosario on again as the seventh round winds down. Start the eighth round now in San Juan, Puerto Rico, the WBC World Lightweight Championship. Edwin Rosario, who has not fought in nearly a year in the black trunks. Jose Luis Ramirez in the dark blue trunks. Ramirez on the left here in the eighth round. Rosario, for the most part, has controlled the pace and tempo of this fight. Ramirez did come back with a good round in the seventh to make a good case for giving it to him. Again, referee Arthur Mercanni does not score. The three judges at ringside do. 10-point must have. And under the relatively recent WBC edict, a 12-round championship fight, not 15. We're in the eighth. Pressure again here put on by Ramirez. But Rosario gets him backing away again with two quick sticking left jabs. So Rosario throughout the fight exhibiting the tendency to get himself almost by design, as we said before, backed into a corner and then works his way out with great effectiveness. Ramirez, he's what you might call in boxing terminology, a traitor. Likes to trade blows, as we said, an effective counterpuncher. Ramirez, at the age of 24, a pro since he was 14 years old, so a long road for him. Attempting to culminate it successfully today for the world title. 1 minute remaining in the eighth round. One thing about Rosario, if that right hand has bothered him in any way, he has not exhibited overtly. Again, the fractured wrist. He was in a cast for 4 months after it was originally diagnosed as something other than a fracture. And then intensive training only in the last 6 weeks. 20 seconds remaining. Eighth round. Ramirez pressing, as was the case in the seventh and preceding round. Rosario again working his way out of the corner. And the eighth round is nearly history. It is. That's the time, 4:30 Eastern time, 1:30 on the West Coast, next Saturday. From Churchill Downs in Louisville, we'll see it right here, the Kentucky Derby. Here, ninth round, WBC World Lightweight Championship. Rosario, for the most part, has controlled the pace. And we would have him ahead at this point, yet it has not been what you would call an extremely convincing eight rounds by Edwin. And in a way, he's really manifested his personality. He's not a brash, gregarious, outgoing sort of fella. Relatively quiet. Good left there. And he has fought a basic Rosario fight in a way, quite effective, except that it's not typical in the sense that he's not put his man away very early. That had been the case early on in his career. Good exchange right there. Rosario, early in his career, with a lot of very early knockouts, but again, you have to consider the caliber of opposition. It wasn't that terrific, but he did open everybody's eyes by knocking out Bruyette in three, even though a lot of people felt that Bruyette was over the hill at that point. Halfway through the ninth round, I'd like to alert our local stations. At the end of this round, we'll be taking a station break. Ninth round scheduled, 12-rounder in San Juan. Again now, Ramirez, as has been the case in the last three rounds, has picked up the pace, and he has begun to make the fight. Rosario is doing some occasional scoring. And he's showing good footwork and foot speed. But he has not landed with nearly the effectiveness of late that he did in the middle round. But now here he comes, as if on cue. And of course, Rosario's relative inactiveness, and we say that guardedly, in the last two rounds could be attributed to ring rustiness. Let's face it, he hasn't fought since the end of May of 82. And he's in with a very good lightweight in Ramirez, a man with great experience, and a man who's beginning to score. ABC's Wide World of Sports right after this from our local station. Start the 10th round in San Juan. Al Michaels at ringside. And again, let's emphasize the point. This is a 12-round championship fight. After starting rather strongly, Edwin Rosario perhaps has given up what we had as a rather substantial lead after the first four rounds, as Jose Luis Ramirez has done a good job in the latter rounds, and as a consequence, this one could be closer than we originally thought, or at least thought up until a couple of rounds ago. 10-point must system. Again, the three judges doing the scoring. No voice in the scoring for Arthur McCanny, the referee. Good right hand by Rosario, but Ramirez appears to be able to shake everything off. He has never really been in trouble. He was staggered early on, has come back in fine fashion. Another good right. Rosario would not appear to be having any particular trouble against the southpaw. This is the third time in his career that he's fought a left-hander. Third time reportedly in his career. Halfway through the 10th round. Ramirez, and this has been a posture the two have had with great frequency in this fight. Now Rosario backs away, but Ramirez has had Rosario against the ropes on a couple of occasions. Decent combination just thrown by Rosario, but back comes Ramirez now, pressing the issue. Ramirez stalking him across the ring. Good exchange by the two here in the 10th round, under a minute to go in round 10. And a mouse developing under the left eye of Rosario. Rosario has been only 10 rounds once in his career. As we say, undefeated, and only once had he gone the distance. Ramirez really coming on now here in the latter round and scoring effectively here in the 10th round. Good action-packed round. We approach the 10-second mark in round 10. Rosario and Ramirez for the WBC lightweight championship. We're going to the 11th round, so Rosario early on was controlling things, but Ramirez has really come on. And as a consequence right now, this fight, we would think, would be very, very close. 10-point must system. Again, it begins with Rosario backed against the ropes by Ramirez. Rosario had a mouse developing under his left eye in the 10th round, and that left eye just beginning to close. A little bit here in the 11th round. Puffiness. This is the longest he has ever gone in his career. And he is showing the effects of the lengthiest bout of his career, and also, obviously, the 11-month layoff from the ring, despite the fact he's only 20 years old. Now he begins to come on again, and the crowd responds, but he's unable to follow it up with much. And the pattern in this round, as it's been for the last few, is that Rosario has been giving up ground as Ramirez keeps coming in. Three judges scoring at ringside from Dallas, Las Vegas, and Los Angeles. Spider Bynum, Lou Tabbitt, Lou Filippo. If they're scoring on the basis of aggression, it's Ramirez who's been picking up a lot of points because he has been making the latter half of the fight. In the final minute of round 11, scheduled for 12. Rosario, despite being pressed into the corner, has been landing some effective blows. Good right hand, a good right by Ramirez, but Rosario comes right back at him. Right above us, the southpaw landing a good right hook. The 11th round winding down. We've had plenty of action as we come to you live from San Juan, Puerto Rico. Pre-program note, Battle of the Network Stars annual edition coming up this Wednesday, 9 o'clock, 8 central, here on ABC. Now the crowd really coming to life as we start the 12th and final round under the new WBC rules. World Lightweight Championship at stake. It's been a good one. Rosario and Ramirez in the crowd chanting Chapo, Chapo. The nickname of Edwin Rosario, ranked number one by the WBC. Ramirez, ranked number two. The two battling for Arguello's vacated crown. Rosario, in most corners, was favored coming in. Ramirez, again, pressing the action here. Good right landed there by Ramirez, forcing Rosario back into the corner. Ramirez, certainly the fresher of the two, as this fight winds down. We're halfway through the 12th round. Ramirez, who's been landing some very effective blows in the second half of this fight. Again, pressuring Rosario. He still has that mouse underneath his left eye, that eye partially closing in the last three rounds. So the southpaw out of Mexico in his 87th fight. And Rosario from here in Puerto Rico at the age of 20 with a minute remaining here in San Juan. Both men showing throughout their careers the ability to knock their opponents out and normally do it very early. But this one apparently will go the distance with 40 seconds remaining in the 12th round. Again, another good right hand by Ramirez. He's not landing the overwhelming punches, but he has done a tremendous amount of scoring. Good exchange here, and Rosario came out of that corner with a good right hand. But again, it's Ramirez showing no ill effects at all. And again, backing Rosario into the corner. So this one winding down, and we've had a lot of action in it from San Juan. Ramirez and Rosario. And there it is. It's all over, and it's interesting. And Arthur McCanny, no voice in the scoring. Here's the decision.